Hope you're doing well. I want to appreciate you for subscribing. And today I'll be giving a shout out to my fan, my first viewer, Ivy Chamara. So thank you so much, girl, for being the first one to view each and every time. So today I'll be talking about something so interesting, and I hope you're going to enjoy. We'll be talking about questions that should never be asked on the first date. You know, there are two types of dates. One is the magical date. This is the one that you don't even realize how time passes until maybe the owner of the restaurant tells you, hey, guys, it's time to close. And there are these dates whereby you just feel like in the next 10 minutes of reaching there, you feel like you're in the wrong place and you just want to clear the table and go. And what makes it feel this way? Maybe from the type of question people ask. There are questions that you ask and they feel offensive, they feel immature. So those are the questions that we'll be talking about. So I'm just going to give you a few questions. Then you may also give me the questions that you think that you should never be asked on the first date. So the first question that for me, I feel like this is so offensive, so uncalled for, is when somebody asked me, like, how many sex partners have you had in your life? Like, that question is personal. That information is personal. So how do I go on to tell a stranger, a person I've just met today, and I'm not even so sure that we're going to meet again? So that question is so personal. And for me, if somebody asks me that question, I feel offended. And that's a question that I will never wish somebody to ask me on the first date. So that's a bad question. That's my opinion, but it's a bad question to ask on the first date. How many sex partners have you had? That's so personal. That's information that I want to keep to myself. So that's a bad question to ask on the first date. The second question that, for me, I feel that that question is not good. Somebody asking about my tribe. Like, what tribe are you? Why should you be so interested about my tribe unless you're tribalistic? So, either if I'm a Taita, if I'm a Kamba, if I'm a Luo, are you interested in my tribe or are you interested in the person that you see there? So that is a question that you should never ask, at least not on the first date. So if we have a chance to know each other, by the end of the day, by the end of the month, if you are still going to see each other, you're going to know that. But asking that on the first date, that one is so bad. I will feel that this person is tribalistic. And if you love a person, the tribe doesn't matter, according to me. So that's a question you should never ask on the first date. When you ask me, I feel that you are so tribalistic and you're not a person that I should associate with. The other question, which feels so uncalled for, not good, people will ask you, what type of job do you do? Or others are even so, they're so confident to ask you the amount of salary you get, imagine, on the first date. Somebody is so confident asking you, how much do you get as your salary? That one is not good. And sometimes, somebody can invite you on a date to his or her house, and somebody is asking, how much is this chair? How much is this TV? Seriously, sis. We know you're broke, but stop acting like heat. Be broke, but act classy. Like, just sit on the sofa comfortable, like things you're so used to, but you start asking everything. How much is the fridge? How much is the sofa? For me, I feel like you're so much materialistic and you're just interested in what I have.
Next question that you should not ask on the first date we have, how many exes have you had? So this question is closely related to how many sex partners you have had. I feel this question is slut shaming. So what if I tell you have had 5? 10? Will your opinion change about me? And when I have decided to come on a date, I have left my past behind and I'm here for the present. So you bringing about the past to this date, it's offensive. Like, I may be getting over a really bad ex. So you bringing that topic so uncalled for and it's so offensive. So please don't ask that question. You can talk about many things. We shall be talking about that on the next video, how to spice up your date. But today we're just talking about those questions that you should never ask. And that one is one. How many exes have you had? Those are personal questions. And you should not be able to tell a stranger. You are a stranger. We have met today. We have not even seen each other. This is the first time we're meeting. And there are things I will never tell you. Next question that you should not ask on a first date is where do you think this relationship is going on the first date? Asking that question, you really sound so foolish, desperate, and so rushy. Like, what if they tell you they don't even like you? You are going to feel so disappointed. So to avoid this kind of disappointment, stop being so expectant. That's something you can ask from the, maybe on the third date, or maybe you let them go, make a decision if they still want you or if they still want to meet you. Because maybe some of them just wanted to come see you and maybe they are not so interested from how you are, which is so bad to say, but people have their likes, they can see you and they don't want to meet you. We are human and it happens. So I don't regret saying that, it happens. So you asking that on the first date is so rushy. Give them time, then you can ask that question. The next question that you should not ask, and maybe is the last one that we'll be talking about today, is where do you want us to go? Like, where do you want me to take you today? People appreciate something which has been planned earlier. Like, I want you to plan before we even meet. Have a plan on how you want us to spend this day. At least have a good plan, like, from watching the movies, we're going to do cycling. From cycling, we're going to do this. But I come dressed to go on a date, maybe to just sit somewhere in a restaurant. And then you're not even so sure. You're asking me, can we go for cycling? Surely. How am I going to cycle with my heels on? So people really appreciate a person who has really planned. Have a plan. So that the person who you're going to meet, that is your date, can dress to the occasion. And trust me, you're going to have a very nice date if you have a plan. Don't have the last minute question like, where can we go? Oh, what do you want to eat? Have a plan, please. And people really appreciate a plan, a well-planned date. So we are done for today. Those are the only questions that I had. So on the comment section, write any question that you feel that I've not tackled. And next, on the next YouTube video that I'm going to make, we may talk about how to spice your date. How do you make that conversation flowing and your date will become so magical until you are reminded like we are closing up and you have to go. So until that time, continue subscribing, continue viewing. Bye bye for now.